My name is Cheryl Hamilton, and today I want to show you a beautiful card using the Faux Mother of Pearl technique. Can you see the little shimmer on some of the... Yeah, I think you can see it. So I'm going to show you how to do that and how to put this card together, because there's a bunch of different elements here from the Sand and Sea Suite. First, I want to show you this beautiful suite. It's in the mini catalog on page 40. I think it's 40 through 41. So look at all these beautiful cards. I just, it's kind of endless what you can do with this suite. So, you know, there's a really nice embossing folder, and these are dies and beautiful paper. Let me see on the next page. Yeah, this is the stamp set. Pretty fonts and sentiments, and I love all the shells. So I'm going to show you the products in person a little better. So here's my card again, the first one I've made out of many things you can do. The embossing folder is a huge thing of seashells, very nice. Opal rounds are just these glimmery little dots, neat embellishments. Here's the stamp set that coordinates with this die. Here's the huge one. So there's a really big one, and then there's a couple of little seashells, and I barely started using this. It's pretty great. So, oh, here's the paper. This is really pretty. I like pastels, so this was really nice. What did I miss? Here's a red one. There you go. And then turn it over, and those are really, really neat papers too. So you might want to get just the paper. It's called Sand and Sea Designer Series paper. Okay, so let me show you a little bit about how to get started. I'm starting with a piece of seaside spray paper that's just cut 5.5 by 4.25. And I'm going to do my technique on here, the Faux Mother of Pearl. So to do that, I'm using Frost White Shimmer Paint. Shake it really well. I don't use this very much except for this technique, or in the when I'm doing like trees for Christmas cards with snow on them and stuff, it's really pretty to just paint a little on there. But with this, I'm just going to do a drop. This is a really little jar, so I don't want to waste it. You know, it's did two little drops. I'm taking a piece of saran wrap, scrunching it all up like this, and then I'm gonna dip it in here. And I'm getting it so that I don't have a big blob of it on there. And then I'm gonna do it on, I'm gonna dab it all over my shimmer, what's it called? Seaside spray paper. You do wanna definitely leave some spots that don't have this on it, because that's the parts that are gonna collect more color. It's just more interesting if you do it not all the same. Let's see if there's any more in here. I think that's about it. I'll see if you guys can see it. Yeah, you can kind of see that. Okay, I'm just gonna let it dry for a minute or two. And then I'll emboss. What will I do? I cut it first and then emboss. Okay. So now we're going to use the embossing folder. It's Seashells 3D. You take what you've cut out and you place it in here, just lining it up. You can see where the shells and these seaweed things are. So line it up as well as you can. There, that looks really good. Okay, and then we're gonna run it through. And there you go. It's even more interesting now. Another thing you could have done is after you cut it out, you could have stamped it. I'll do another one like that so you can see the difference. Okay, so to complete my card base is Seaside Spray 8.5 by 5.5, scored down the middle at 4.25. And no, I didn't get my nails done on purpose for this card. That would be fun. I was thinking of when I have In Color Club starting again in the summer, I should do my nails a different in color every month. I'm gonna take this and just put a little bit of a little bit of Tombow around. I just don't like when the glue oozes out. I'd rather have some parts not glued down. So that's probably enough. I'm gonna put it down on here. And just pat it down. You can put more glue if there's parts that are bothering you. But as long as it's sticking, once the Tombow dries, it's really a great glue. It won't come off. So there's what I have there. And I wanna do the part with the sentiment now. So let me put this here. I'm gonna grab some basic white scrap paper, and I'm gonna stamp a sentiment on it. And they have some nice ones in this set. Look at, they have Happy Birthday to My Beautiful Friend, which is what I'm gonna use right now. You're unique and completely amazing. Friends are like seashells. You collect them along the way, and some different ones. I really like that. But I'm gonna do this one. And when you stamp, I still see lots of people in classes that just cram this down here and it gets ink all over the place and it's a mess. And also when you have little teeny font like the T-O, if you ink it up too much, it's going to fill in the middle of that O right there, and it won't be as nice of an image. So that's why I just tap, tap, tap like that. And that's a really pretty font. I like that one. I'm going to use Story Label Punch to punch this out. I just turn it upside down and put it in there till I get it in just the right spot, and then do it with two hands and punch it. So I'm going to end up having this on this. I want to add some linen thread to loop around this part. So I'm going to turn it over and put a bunch of dimensionals on it. I'll show you how I do this. I'm putting a lot because I want to loop the thread around. I need something to stick it onto. Oops, take them off. And then I'm just going to loop this. Make little cute little loops. I don't want it to look exactly the same, so I'm trying to do a few. See what that looks like. That's kind of cute. I think I'll just stop. And then, okay, so I'm popping it up on this. Oh, you know what I did? Darn, I don't know if I can do it now. I use a sponge dauber to add a little bit of ink around the edge. So I know it has the twine on it now, so I just made it hard on myself. But this is kind of a fun way to dress up a punch, is you just dab a little bit here and see how it made it kind of blue around the edge. It's really pretty. Okay, I got away with that, I guess. So now I'm gonna stick it to, this is the Designer Series paper, and I cut it out with a Stitch So Sweetly dies, just a rectangle. And that's that back, which would be pretty also, actually. Ooh. Maybe, well, I'll keep it the same. I really like the sandy look of this. To get it in the middle, there you go. And then I pop this up too, just because it's such a fancy card. Also, I think it would have stuck fine to this, but once in a while, if there's big embossing, I'm worried that it wouldn't stick as well. I'm gonna put two more. One in the middle. You guys have these things all over the place. I find them in the weirdest places, even on my dog sometimes. I don't know, but here you go. I don't think this thing was straight. Okay, I think I'm almost done. I'm gonna add these opals rounds. Opal rounds, and isn't that pretty? I like those. Okay, let's do something fun to the inside. I just, you know, I'm kind of doing an over-the-top card, or trying to. There you go. So I just cut some paper, and from that same Designer Series paper from this suite, and put this on the inside. It's just cut probably 4 by 5 1/4, and one more sentiment. I'm going to stamp "Love You to the Beach and Back," because that's really cute, on some basic white cardstock in, which one is this? Misty Moonlight. Oval Occasions is the new punch that has a scalloped one and a smaller oval. It's a really neat punch. I think that's good. I've got that one, and here's a piece of Misty Moonlight that I'm going to cut a scallop out of. Glue those together and just stick it on my card. There you go. So we've got a really pretty birthday card for somebody special. I'm gonna stamp it in a darker ink than I did for my card. For my card, I just stamped in the same color, which was Seaside Spray, and you can't see it real well. This time I'm going to use Misty Moonlight. just kind of line it up where you think the shell is. Not going to be perfect, but there. Oh, that's pretty good. Where did this go? There you go. I used to know the name of these shells. I wish I did still. I can't remember. Ooh, not bad. And this one's kind of upside down where that little nub is right there is the bottom. Okay. So now I'm gonna emboss it. Is another little one. I just saw this. There's this little shell. Okay. Now I got it. I'll stick it in my embossing folder. Okay. Ooh, that's neat. So there's that one compared to this one where I did the faux mother of pearl. So I want to show you the cards that I made with my leftovers just to finish. So this one has the faux mother of pearl on the seaside spray, but I didn't cut it out. I just embossed it. And isn't that beautiful? And this ribbon is really perfect with that. I didn't have much left, but it's called Seaside Spray Metallic Ribbon. And it's number 150446 if you want it. So I really like this card. I had a couple of those embellishments on them, the opal rounds. And then you open, it's friends are like seashells. You collect them along the way and open it. I'm so happy I found you. Isn't that cute? And last one was where I had stamped the darker before I embossed it. This is Misty Moonlight. And then I didn't know what else. It's hard to cover these up because they're so pretty. So I did your unique and completely amazing and found this. These are ornate frames. This one that were like from a Halloween one. And they're gorgeous, aren't they? Really pretty. The number on this is 150664. That they're still in the annual catalog. So thanks so much for watching, everyone. Hope you got some good ideas. Aloha.